good afternoon. Today we have our next session of Agfluencers. My name is Marina Kuzmenko and I am a founder of Agfluencer project. And briefly about what we are doing, we are speaking with inspirational women in agriculture, and they are sharing their nice stories, how do they reach their level, and we hope that these conversations will be helpful for other ladies who are working in agritech, and they will get some energy to move on. And today our guest is Maria Achkar. I am very happy to meet you, Maria. Thank you for your time for joining us. And Maria is co-founder of Greener Crop. It's a company which is based in United Arab Emirates. And let's start from the early stage of your professional career, Maria. Can you tell us a little bit about yourself and about your education in Holy Spirit University? Please tell us about that.
Thank you, Marina, for having me, and thank you for hosting this this call. My name is Maria. I am the head of business development and co-founder at Greener Crop. We are based in the UAE, as you mentioned. And to answer your question, I have always been curious about where our food comes from and how it's made. And actually, being born in Lebanon quite often means that you're born into a third or fourth generation farming family. You're mostly surrounded by fertile land. And a big part of our culture revolves around food and heritage. And so this is the first way in to know what you like and what you're curious about. And then joining the Holy Spirit University of Kislik, where I studied biochemistry and then followed by agri-food engineering, helped me actually dive deeper into the technical, scientific, and experimental part of agriculture. And I think I am very grateful for this experience, because the topics and the variety of courses that we had access to was a good balance of technical agriculture, theoretical, on-site, experimental, deeply scientific, delivered mostly by ag enthusiasts and by industry leaders. And I'm actually the first encountering, or my first introduction into entrepreneurship was when I was during my first year of my master's degree.
Please tell us about that project. What was the project?
So yeah, during my first master's degree year, where I was studying agri-food engineering, we launched a company that was specialized in recreating locally available products into healthy snacks and innovative products. And so our main aim was to support local farmers, rural farmers, on not only understanding the value of their production, but actually uplifting and making it seem more attractive to younger generation, mm-hmm. to a younger generation.
Yeah, that's nice. That's very interesting, because the moment of transition from you are just biotechnologist and then you decide to apply your knowledge in real life, this is the most probably painful point at the same moment. Do you remember your experience? Did you meet with some specific problems when you started your company? It's called Superfoodie, yes?
Yes, correct. So the company is called Superfoodie, which launched actually two brands, Freaky Bites and another one. And the idea is, when you're part of a scientific program or you study science and engineering, there is a gap in your knowledge between the innovation and what you do and mm-hmm. actually solving a problem and then taking it to the market. And so this was the enlightening part of it, where I fell in love with the process of taking something from a lab or from an idea stage to the market. And I think one of the challenges that you can face is the little understanding and knowledge that we have as scientists and engineers when it comes to financials, to economics, to everything that goes into market. And so mm-hmm. I think this is it. And second of all, the support that we were getting we're grateful for it, and it was a unique support. But I think in other parts of the country and even the world, this is not something available. So we were lucky enough to have this initial support available.
Mm-hmm. And also I saw in your career that you have been working for United Nations organization. Yes. Can you tell us a little bit about that page of your life?
Yeah, so this was an interesting, let's say, addition to my career. I was part of a project that was focused on delivering, let's say, trainings and upskilling for rural farmers and rural producers in Lebanon. The idea was that we were working on having a perfect, or let's say, a ready-to-go-to-the-market product or service, and then being able to market it properly. And you know the challenges when it comes to rural farmers or rural areas, the access to almost a lot of the resources is unavailable. So this was an interesting opportunity for us to understand the different key elements of the chains and to be able to support because, and then again, this was also part of my previous projects.
Mm-hmm. And how does this all experience align with your existing project? So it's greener crop. How did you start it? How did you meet co-founder? As I understand, you have a co-founder, yes?
Yes, so how did this affect greener crop? Well, actually, to start with, it's related to farming. It's related to working directly with farmers, which is some part of what we do.
So what are you doing if it's just a part? So what is the whole picture?
Yeah, absolutely. So maybe let me give you an intro on greener crop.
Yes,
greener crop is on a mission to change the way we source our food in the region and potentially worldwide. And we want to do this by enabling the deployment of future farming solutions at a meaningful scale, including hydroponic farming, aquaponic farming, and so on. So we do this by providing by being a one-stop destination that couples cutting-edge technology, farming technologies, as well as our unique data-driven farm management solutions. And so the idea is the problems that we have in our region to start with are, unavailability of arable land, the disrupted supply chains, and the fact that we import almost everything that we eat, the severe weather conditions when it comes to high temperatures, high humidity levels, a lot of exposure, and fourth, the unavailability of the talent or the skills that would help us deploy or have these farms available and profitably operation. So this is why Greener Crop was created, is because we have these problems. Mm-hmm. And from the first look of it, it looks like hydroponic farming, future farming solutions, whatever, vertical farming seems to be the good solution for such problems. Mm-hmm. However, it has not been deployed at a meaningful scale because there are a lot of barriers to entry in the market, whether from supply chain, access to technology, and mostly because there is no horticultural experience, data gathering, data sharing on the ground. So this is what we're aiming to do by providing the unique hydroponic farm management solution, which is both based on industry knowledge, data collection and data analytics, and then actual operations of these farms.
Okay, so as I understand you, if some farmer has a hydroponic farm, he can come to you and you will help him with what?
Okay, so I'll answer the question differently. We work with a lot of client segments, such as governmental entities, educational institutions, food producers, and farmers at the end of the day. So farmers, if they have conventional farming or they're interested to get into the hydroponic farming or future farming solutions, the way in is actually reaching out to Greener Crop. Our team of consultants would advise on the best technology available for such projects, would advise on the best crops to have in certain regions based on crop strategy and analytics. And the most interesting part of it is actually the farm management and operations, which is backed by data and our platform.
Okay. and how do you work in greener crop? Do you have subscription for farmers, or how do they pay for their participation and work with you?
So it's a tailor-made service that we provide for each client based on their needs. It mm-hmm. can come in terms of a subscription to a bundle of support that mm-hmm. we give, or to a full actual service on site. So I'm going to give you an example. We have a project in the UAE where the farms that are set for the individual or the investor are fully run by our team from A to Z, covering supply chain, covering human resources, covering equipment and tools, covering anything that's needed to run a farm.
I understand. So you provide actually fully customized solution for whatever need you have for specific farm. Okay, nice. Thank you, Maria. And I understand that such deep knowledge in the problems means that you have had a lot of meetings and the huge experience of work within the industry. So in your opinion, how does it feel to work in the industry of agritech, biotechnology? Is it difficult for female leaders like you, or it's still fair enough, we can cope with that?
It is a challenging sector to be involved in, like that's a given. But I think being part of Greener Crop and the way like our company culture and our CEO Alexander, the way we support and empower women comes in as a very nice opportunity to be joining this industry right now. And it's funny because women in agriculture is not something new. And I was reading a book by Caroline Perez, and she was arguing the fact that our whole evolution is based on man, the hunter. However, what were women doing, or there's a gap in what the women were doing during this era of our ancestors. And so women, the gatherers, which means we are already into farming. This is not something very much highlighted, but we are there and we were there. And I think it's quite uncommon in our region for women to be involved in agriculture as a first part, and second, to be in leading positions. And I think it's our role to do this. If we know we have company cultures like ours, if we know there's an evolution, almost all the established companies and even older ones, to support women and to involve them in decision making and so on, I think that's the way in. But yeah, it is a challenging area when it comes to higher level of management and being exposed to the different segments of the market.
Yes, I understand you absolutely. And our previous guests, we actually can make a secret club and share these views, because almost every lady has this challenging experience. Yeah, that's true. And so let's go to the positive side. So where do you get inspiration to continue to improve your greener crop and find new customers, do business development? What inspires you?
Yeah, that's an interesting question. First of all, I think being surrounded by supportive people in the company, whether it's our teammates or our CEO Alexander, makes it really easy for us to be excited about what we're doing. Looking at solving the problems that we see in the region is a main driver, because we know this problem is not going to be solved by me only or by my team only. It requires the full involvement of the ecosystem, but it requires efforts all the time. So waking up and deciding not to do this effort is meaningless. And mm-hmm. then I think a very big part of what we do is looking at enabling and having agriculture become more exciting in the region and worldwide. Like, this is not, we're into tech, we're like teenagers are into tech, they're into NFTs, design, whatever. But looking at agriculture as an exciting, sector or opportunity requires us to be excited in the beginning. And this is something that I really look forward maybe at some point to become inspirational in the the field. So mostly looking at it from us being like, we can become the leaders in deployment of agriculture. We need to be excited about it, and we need to show this. How do we work on reaching more clients? So this is what we need to do as part of our day-to-day business. And we know there is a need. We know what the problem that we're solving. And so if we focus on this, I think that's it for us.
Okay, and probably it's traditional, the final question when I ask ladies about the, maybe you are following some person, maybe you are excited about some historical hero or someone who is making you happy, and maybe you can advise us as well, whom to follow and whom to read. You already mentioned the book, that's nice, but maybe something else?
I think one person that I find inspiring currently in the field is Minister Mariam Almheiri, who happens to be the Minister of Climate Change and Environment in the UAE. She is behind the strategy for food security. She is behind the foodtech valley. Like her education and her involvement in the sector makes it really interesting for women in the region to look at her as an inspiration and at the work she does. A book. So I think the book that I mentioned, which is called Invisible Woman, which is it's interesting. It looks at the gap in how the world is designed today to fit in for women and men. And then another book that I would recommend is The Unfair Advantage by Ash Ali, and I forgot the second author. This book that explores, as let's say the first time that explores luck being as part of the success of entrepreneurs in their journeys. So that's an interesting book. A historical hero, I'm not sure I have.
Everything is fine. You have already mentioned such interesting.
It's a good thing to think of it anyway.
Yes. So thank you so much, Maria. You gave us a lot of positive energy today, and it's nice to know more about the greener crop. And thank you so much for your time. We wish you good luck in your business, and we will be very happy to see you on the top level of Forbes journal. And then we'll be extremely happy that we also contributed a little bit to your success.
Thank you so much, Marina. Thank you so much for having me. And good luck with your project.
Yes, thank you. Have a nice day. Bye.
Bye.